Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to react to one of my absolute favorite drummers, and he's really the first drummer that I really sat down and paid attention to back in middle school. Like, I mean, all my music friends were getting into like artists, and you know, I mean pretty much everybody in middle school were getting into artists and stuff like that, but my music friends were like, oh yeah, you know, the drummer friends were like, oh, this drummer, blah blah blah. And I really wasn't, you know, that interested in anything. So I really needed to start listening to some drummers. And my dad, big Rush fan. So that's really who I started paying attention to first. And lo and behold, Neil Peart is a heck of a drummer. So today I wanted to go ahead and take a look at Tom Sawyer by Rush. And I really wanted to watch it in an analytical sense, in a more practiced sense, now that I've been drumming for so long. You know, back then it was just, oh, that sounds cool, I want to emulate that. But now with much more experience under my belt, I really want to take a look at and analyze it from a musical perspective, as well as from a drumming perspective, to really get a feel for the song with new, fresh eyes. So without further ado, let's get right into it. Okay, so the first thing I want to hit is, let's talk about that hand speed in the right hand on the hi-hats. Now, 16th notes at 80, 85 beats per minute doesn't seem hard, but really if your chops aren't, you know, at a high level, or at least an intermediate level, so to speak, then that's really hard. I know, at least for me when I was younger, that I could not play this, because this was one of the first songs I was like, yeah, that's so cool, I want to play that. And now I try and get those 16 notes going, not happening. Oh, good. So if we take a look at it, he's really, we're 23 seconds into the video and I'm already talking about technique. But if we take a look at what's going on here in that right hand, he's really using that molar stroke to get all, you know, what is it, 16 notes in a measure out. You know, that whole idea of two notes in one. So the arm is getting one, the wrist is getting another one. So you're getting that molar stroke to get a really, in my opinion, clean 16 note pattern here, which is phenomenal. And it really is the way I would approach this situation, because keeping that wrist going at that tempo for a 5 minute song, is, you're gonna get so tired so fast. Molar is really the way that you gotta go with that. At least that's the way I would go. Can we just talk about Geddy Lee here for a minute and talk about, first of all, that vocal range? It is just an insane amount of vocal range. And not just that, you know, watching this, hearing it with a practiced ear, with a practiced eye, his intonation is just so good. And his melody is so variant along the spectrum, but his intonation is just so clean, so good. Back to the 16 note pattern for Neil Peart. Can we just talk about how much talent is in this room right now? You got Geddy Lee over here jumping from bass to synthesizer to vocals. You know, you gotta do different shots just to get everything in. Everything that Geddy Lee is doing, you gotta do a different shot. So you've got Geddy Lee over here doing all this crazy stuff, and then you've got one of the best drummers, in my opinion, that I've ever seen play in Neil Peart, because he's so versatile, and you don't really see that versatility in his Rush stuff, but I've seen some of his jazz stuff, and he's just, I mean, how much talent is in that room right now? It's phenomenal. It's just great. Can we just take a moment and appreciate the fact that this part of the song is not in 4/4 time? When do you ever hear that nowadays? I mean, I'm sure it's somewhere. I haven't heard a 7/8 time signature in mainstream music in a long time. If you have, let me know in the comments. I'd love to check it out. But I just wanted to sit down and appreciate that 7/8 time signature. Also, next thing, I just need to stop and appreciate that melody trade-off that we just saw. It's so cool. I just really appreciate that melody and how it was traded off from place to place. First, you start off with Geddy Lee on the synthesizer playing that melody on the synthesizer. Then we get an overlay of electric guitar on top of the synthesizer. And now we got Geddy Lee back on bass playing the melody as a bass line on the bass guitar. It's just such good composition. What a great buildup to the drum solo, and what great composition in the drum solo as well. There's really nothing technically difficult about his drum solo, but it's just so clean and well executed, and it serves the song. It's not really like, hey, check me out. I mean, it is. There are check me out moments in the drum solo, particularly the second bit, but it really serves the song, and it's so synonymous with Tom Sawyer that it's really become iconic. I'm pretty sure if anybody went to go see these guys live or anything like that and they were not to hear that exact drum solo, there would be some pretty upset people in that crowd. What a cool little video moment to show us the many faces of Geddy Lee. In the background, we've got Geddy Lee on the synth, and then in a little window, you've got Geddy Lee on vocals as well as bass guitar. It's just, what a great little moment. What a great transition. I need me some of those classes. Yep, oh. Exit the warrior today's Tom Sawyer, he gets high on you. Energy trade, he gets right on to the friction of the day. What a cool stance. Like four synths. One hand on one, the other hand on the other. It just makes you look like you know what you're doing. Oh, let's take that up the octave. Very cool moment. And that's pretty much it. Thanks so much for stopping by and joining me on this video watching and listening journey that I just went on into, I guess, my childhood. It's not really my childhood because, you know, Rush is not my childhood. It is technically, but they weren't popular. I mean, I guess they were popular. You know what I mean. They were at their height in, like, before my time. But I had a great time. I can't wait to look at some more songs, some more drummers. I want to talk about a really... I just discovered this drummer, and I love the way she plays. And I really want to watch one of her videos and react to it here with you guys because I think, you know, she's amazing. Anyway, thanks so much for watching. If you like the video, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you really like the video and want to see more stuff like this, reacting videos as well as lessons, I mentioned it in my last video, I think that I'm thinking about doing some drum set stuff, obviously. So if you're into that kind of stuff, subscribe, and hopefully we will see you guys next time. See ya.